tube in home, while another one you're left defenseless, like in the Las Vegas shooting.
Okay, so some pros and cons about gun control laws. The first argument is a pro, which is gun control laws will not stop gun use. Instead, gun use has increased in areas where carrying guns is prohibited. So, an example is the District of Columbia. They issued a law banned on that when they how they banned handgun possession. They made it illegal to carry an unregistered firearm, and they also banned the registration of handguns. So they kind of made it impossible for people to have any like handguns or any firearms of any type. So this caused the U.S. Supreme Court in 2008 to rise the District of Columbia versus Heller, when a policeman named Anthony Heller he was trying to register for a gun, but he was denied. So he filed this suit, and so at the end of it, he won because they couldn't really stand it. He used the Second Amendment to protect his right to possessing a firearm. And so this U.S. Supreme Court decision, it kind of demonstrates both sides of the first argument. The second argument is owning a gun has helped people feel safe at home. So going back to the previous U.S. Supreme Court I just mentioned, Heller, he felt more comfortable, more safer with having a gun. So that's why he used the Second Amendment to protect that. And so the third argument is that most suicides are done by using firearms, and we'll go into it more in the next slide, but to kind of give you an overview, suicides are kind of below the amount, like suicides with firearms are below the amount of homicides with firearms. And so the fourth argument is gun control laws deny people's sense of safety. So going back to the example of the 15-year-old boy who was protecting him and his sister with his dad's rifle, that kind of shows how, especially when like a home intruder, you're trying to feel safe. So if you have nothing to protect yourself with, that's something that denies people's sense.
Okay, so suicide is very common in California and obviously in the United States. It's usually like very common among teens, although it does like affect other ages. In this case, suicide with firearms is actually very common in California, and it's although up there it says that suicide isn't like as much as accidents with firearms. That's actually like not true. Suicide is a lot more common than homicides and accidents with firearms. So, throughout like time, incidents with firearms, like murders, have gone down, but suicides have not. It's actually very common with white male over the age of 50, because they have like easier access to firearms compared to teens and other people of like other ages. Also, the people that are more affected with this are white Californians, because they're about 3 times as likely as blacks and roughly 6 times as likely as Hispanics to kill themselves with firearms. Although black Californians are 2 times more likely to die from firearm related than whites and Hispanics, are 4 times more likely with murders and accidents. So yeah, like I said, age does matter in this case because they're firearms. In the United States, the suicide rate is a lot higher than other countries. So compared to Mexico, it's 6.3 compared to Mexico is 0.44, and Yeah, Mexico has like very strict gun law controls with the gun control laws, even though, Mexico has lower suicide rates because of this, and basically their gun control law is the same as the United States, but it's a lot stricter, and their law is like the Second Amendment, and but they their law is they have the right to keep arms and not carry them as long as you're like a private citizen. Like you can only have them in your home. You can't carry them around unless you're part of the military or a police officer, bodyguard, a politician.
All right. Suicide. Why mention suicide? As mentioned in the previous slide, gun control won't necessarily decrease the suicide attempt rates, but it may significantly decrease the successful suicide attempt rates. As you can see by the graph, guns are by far the most fatal method of suicide. You would have a better chance of surviving suicide if you were to use any other method besides a gun. And people who support gun control may argue that people who own guns are 2 to 10 times more likely to commit suicide. And that's because once you have those suicidal thoughts, it's very easy to, you know, pick up a gun and squeeze the trigger, because guns are considered the fastest, painless, and I guess the most efficient way of killing yourself. But next slide. But on the contrary, those against gun control may say that do not blame the gun. It is the responsibility lies within the individual, meaning that we cannot blame the suicide problem on guns. We should blame it, or not necessarily blame it, but it's the responsibility of the person who owns the gun, whether or not they should, you know, be even thinking those thoughts. Because guns make it easier to commit suicide, but in the end, they cannot be blamed for the final decision. And as I said earlier, suicidal individuals will find other methods for suicide, such as hanging, wrist cutting, jumping, overdose, and etc. And so, you don't necessarily need a gun to commit suicide. If you're very eager to do that or do so, there are other methods. Of course, suicide is never the answer, but there you go.
So, in conclusion, we hope that you guys have learned more about the pros and cons of gun control, strict gun laws, or having more relaxed ones. It's an ongoing problem, you know, not having much of a solution, and we are the only country that has as many mass shootings as we do. No other country does. It's pretty awful. So it is something that we kind of need to come together and like find a solution for. Obviously, protecting the Second Amendment is important to a lot of American citizens, and I think that is something that we should protect, but it shouldn't be as easy as it is at the same time to be able to get your hands on some of those kinds of dangerous weapons. So, like I said, inclusion is good for, keeping yourself safe and stuff, and like protecting yourself, but at the same time, there is mass shootings, and these things happen like 4 or 5 times every year, and it's just like we're sad and we cry, and then like weeks later we're like, okay, what's next? Like, when's the next one? So, and this could happen to you